can be what you want to be if you try to be what you can be. Hey, black child, do you know where you're going? Where you're really going? Do you know you can learn what you want to learn if you try to learn what you can learn? Hey, black child, do you know you are strong? I mean really strong. Do you know you can do what you want to do if you try to do what you can do? Hey, black child, be what you can be. Learn what you must learn. Do what you can do. And tomorrow, your nation will be what you want it to be.
Grateful that my mom and my grandmother taught me about my history. It's really important because even when I was in places and I was growing up and I didn't fit in, I always knew that I belonged. I remember my grandmother telling me stories about MLK Boulevard, Mount Vernon, and Long Street, and how they used to call that Million Dollar Avenue, where they said $1 million would pass through everybody's hands on those streets. I remember hearing stories from my grandfather about Flytown, how they really, really had a sense of community because everybody knew where they came from. It's just so important. So this evening, I want to welcome you to Columbus Black History and the Black History Program, brought to you by Brittsmart and Studio B. We want to thank them for sponsoring this evening. And tonight, Columbus Black History, we're going to talk about the start of 1803 and 200 years in which African Americans have brought history and American history to Columbus, Ohio, and all the things that really make us one Columbus. This would be the time where I would introduce the historian and visionary, Rita Fuller-Yates. But I need everybody out there to send her some prayers and love and light because she's not feeling so well. So Rita Fuller-Yates has worked tirelessly to put together Columbus Black History. The Rita Fuller-Yates brand works to educate, connect, and inspire people about the contributions of African Americans and what they have done in Columbus, Ohio. Rita especially has worked hard to make sure that she could educate the next generation, talking about the importance of Black history in a way that's palatable to them and how they learn. Rita is a connector. She's a sister, a friend, a neighbor. If you haven't logged on to the page Columbus Black History, we ask that you do that tonight. We also ask that you share it with friends so that they can enjoy and understand all of the contributions that African Americans have made to make Columbus great. Tonight, we're going to learn more about four historians, Black historians, who have been able to keep Columbus great by talking about their contributions, the history, and making sure that they maintain community by sharing with people stories of the past in order to connect to the future. At this time, we're going to learn more about our next clip, which will take you on a journey of Columbus and 200 years of contributions that African Americans have made.
Columbus has always had a rich African-American history. From the late 1800s to present day, we've always been on the move. It's as if every street has a story to tell. And our very own community historian, Rita Fuller-Yates, is here to tell it.
Oh, girl, Do your thing.
Go, girl.
That's right. Your homegirl's on the scene. She's out here uncovering the facts and sharing the history in the streets. Let's go.
I am standing on the bridge of I-71 at the intersect of Long Street, parallel to Spring Street. This area in the early 1900s was better known as the Bronzeville District, where many Black leaders, politicians, professionals, artists, and entrepreneurs started their humble beginnings. Behind me, you will notice some of their beautiful Black faces. These leaders helped build, support, and motivated a part of the Black community during a time when Black people were equivalent to a horse and buggy. These particular leaders, like James Poindexter, Al Jackson, and historian Rita Smith, just to name a few, were visionary leaders that saw the better good of the Black community. They helped establish social and financial infrastructures that would ultimately create the communities many of us live in today and the legacies that many of us belong to. We will dig deep and you will also learn the communities where Black people settled when we first ventured to Columbus, Ohio from southern states of the country. We will take you to the communities that still remain today, and you will learn the significant Black leaders that helped build businesses, social enterprises, and educational programs to ensure constant growth in the African American community for over 200 years. During this four-course video, students will begin the journey with learning the specific places where the Underground Railroad stops were and still remain in Columbus till this very day.
We will begin our journey understanding the Black person's fight from the beginning of the state of Ohio in 1803 and how the Underground Railroad system was used in Columbus to assist runaway slaves from one destination to the other. We will travel from old communities in downtown Columbus to the crafty cities of Westerville and Delaware, where slaves would travel to and from in the middle of the night for safety and security.
While we make our way to our first destination, I think it's important while we travel to share the history of African American music. We actually helped to create a sound now recognized as distinctly American music. The Black music became a reflection of both hardships and triumphs, and our music helped shape the national music identity. The Fisk Jubilee Singers are one of the examples of recorded Black music and its impact on America. We are now listening to Go Down Moses that was recorded in 1871 by the Fisk Jubilee Singers. Traveling to our next destination, better known as the Lucy Dent Park, which is located at 6381 Harriet Road in Powell, Ohio. If you drive along Dublin Road past Shawnee Hills in Delaware County, you'll pass a sign that reads, Lucy Depp Park. Have heard of the system of the Underground Railroad and slaves that traveled on this path. But many of us are unfamiliar with the role that Columbus, Ohio played in the Underground Railroad. Before we take a walk through the park of Lucy Depp, let's watch a short story on the Underground Railroad and how Columbus, Ohio played a huge role.
Before the Civil War in 1861, thousands of runaways escaped slavery by traveling north through Ohio on a system known as the Underground Railroad. It was a loose system of safe stations where abolitionists and humanitarians gave aid and shelter to formerly enslaved people.
Rivers and creeks along the Ohio River in Delaware and the Lucy Depp community were used for travel by the slaves to help conceal tracks from bounty hunters and their bloodhounds.
Lucy Depp Park was a 102-acre development named for Lucinda Depp. She had inherited the land from her father, Abraham, an emancipated African-American man and Central Ohio pioneer from Powhatan County, Virginia. Known historically as the Depp Settlement, Robert Good, a nephew of Lucy and her husband Thomas White, purchased the land and developed it as Lucy Depp Park in the mid-1920s. The park became a popular vacation spot as well as home site for African American families from Columbus and elsewhere in the segregated America before the civil rights movement of the 1950s and 60s. According to a brochure Good used to promote the development, Lucy Depp Park, for people who care.
In 1835, freed slave Abram Depp brought his family from Virginia and settled on 300 acres in Concord Township, purchased from Joseph Sullivan. Upon settling this land, Abram established a Baptist church and an underground railroad station using a limestone cave along the Scioto River to hide the runaway slaves until a bell was rung at the barn on the property, signaling all is clear. This is the actual bell that Abraham Depp had rung to when the slaves were running during the Underground Railroad. Of course, this was the place that they would migrate to, and the bell would ring to signify it is time for them to come to this particular place, because it is clear. That's what the sound of this bell is. And it's so much bigger than the sound because it has so much history and legacy to it.
The Depp family settlement grew to 1,500 acres in southern Delaware County, Union, and Franklin counties. Abram had three children with his first wife, Mary, who happened to pass on the trip to Ohio from Virginia. Their son attended Oberlin College and later joined the 27th Ohio Colored Troops and fought in the Civil War. Abram had six children with second wife China, one of whom is Lucy Depp White. Upon Abram's passing, Lucy went to live with a nephew, Robert Good. Robert lived on this property and later named the community Lucy Depp Park in 1932. He turned Lucy Depp Park into a summer resort for affluent African Americans, encouraging building summer cottages and some permanent homes to this very day.
If you were to ask me who the mother of Columbus Black history was, one name that stands out is Dr. Anna Bishop. Her continued efforts to educate Columbus Black history has been noted through her works in Columbus Public Schools, her writings in books and poetry, and the author of Beyond Poindexter Village, The Blackberry Patch. She told the amazing stories of people in her community like James Jackson and James Poindexter, while also mentioning the everyday person, like the ragman. We recognize Dr. Anna Bishop as one of Columbus's great storytellers and historians, and this is why she is this year's recipient of the Respect History Award.
Listen, violent crimes are happening every day in our community. If you take a life and you go to prison, how many lives are affected? Entire families are broken. Their child, your child loses a parent. Their parent, your parent loses a child. Let's talk to young people. Even if you don't know them, smile, encourage them, mentor them. Change a life. This might save a life. This is Marlon Gary, Marlon Gary Funeral Home. Stop the violence. We don't want your business that bad.
Should respect and honor. Rita Smith was so encouraging in her convictions that she was going to chain herself to a tree outside of Poindexter Village just to make sure that the city did right by the people who brought such vibrancy to this community.
Rita Smith's family is one of the original families of Columbus, and her rich family history is only the beginning of how the Smith family has made an impact. Smith has always been a servant for the Columbus community, having humble beginnings on the hilltop of Columbus. Rita Smith's mission to join fellow Eastsiders to help save our nation's first public housing community, the Poindexter Village. In late 2020, Rita and other leaders from the community partnered with The Ohio State University to renovate a portion of the village to become a museum for the education of future generations. In addition to Rita's work with Poindexter Village Society, she has the honor of leading the City of Columbus with a few history initiatives, including the African American Settlements Report. We recognize Rita Smith as one of Columbus's great storytellers and historians. And this is why she is this year's recipient of the Respect History Award.
I'm honored and really humbled because this is a gift I've been given to look for our history and to record our history. It's my gift that's given to me. And it's a blessing to be able to share it with others. So in accepting this, I accept it for all of those that have come before me and all of those that will come after, that we all will respect our history and respect our stories. And in that way, we love each other and we have a sense of hope. And that is what our forefathers have given, left us, is that sense of hope. Because they have struggled to allow us to be here today. And if they didn't, if they had maintained that sense of integrity, and I'm happy that I can follow in Reverend Poindexter's, share his story, because he was a man of integrity. He was a man of respect. He was our beacon. And he was our Martin Luther King of his day. So in all their names, if they hadn't recognized the importance of maintaining what the Lord had given them in terms of that sense of, again, integrity and honesty and all of that, none of us would be here. I'm humbled. This is absolutely gorgeous, and I am
John Payne and Vision Realty came through again. Yeah. And, you know, the name Vision Realty is not just a name that's pulled out of the air. I think what Don Payne does and his team is he allows your vision to come to pass. So the name Vision Realty is really about your vision. It has nothing to do with the real estate business. It's about your vision, and Don Payne and his team did it again.
Come check us out soon at visionrealty.com.
On any given day, you can stop by Dr. George Miller's art shop on Parsons Avenue, like many of us have done for the past 30 years. Dr. George Miller has been a staple in the Black community as an entrepreneur, beginning with his car wash on Long Street and later carryouts. Dr. Miller's passion to mentor young men in between selling art, all while showcasing positivity, hope, and optimism for the Black community. Dr. Miller's work as an entrepreneur, historian, community activist, college professor, and all-around great man will always be cherished. His willingness to share authentic history stories of Columbus remains one of the highlights to visiting Dr. Miller. We recognize Dr. George Miller as one of Columbus's great storytellers and historians, and this is why he is this year's recipient of the Respect History Award.
Oh, wow. Yeah, to let them know that it says for your dedication to Columbus Black history, it is the Respect History Award, Dr. George Miller, presented by Rita Fuller-Yates. Well, thank you very much. It is really, you know, with great pleasure, and to use one of the words here, respect, to receive this award, because a lot of the times when we are just moving along, we do not, which I have never done any particular thing for the intention of getting a particular award. So therefore, it is really great pleasure to receive something that you really did not, number one, know that you were getting, and number two, not something that you achieved by being specifically on purpose. So thank you very much.
Take my hand, leave. Represents a group of leaders, change agents, and citizens for equality from young to old. Our mission focuses on three key areas: education, access, and action.
Well, I marched through the storm, and I marched through the rain, and I marched through some sickness and some heartache and pain.
Our fundamental goals are to seek to understand, then teach while engaging our community leaders to formulate a plan to push us towards a more fair and equitable society. Our initiatives include voter registration, understanding white privilege, media fairness, marketing, youth engagement, philanthropy, police accountability, and inequality.
I'm gonna sing out.
Gonna march on.
I'm gonna march on.
Our teams are working diligently today to ensure change tomorrow.
Take a deep breath.
As we destroy racism
and eradicate
the police abuse and societal trauma
in order to heal
a nation
for what we have endured
for way too long.
The baby with Black and White this summer. Music is very important. This next person has a lot of generations that have been up on their feet when he had his Creole funk band. His music embodies jazz, but probably the most significant thing that he has done as an author and historian is what he does when he tells stories to kids, often telling them that, like jazz, when they make mistakes, you can just keep going and change your tune. So now we honor Arnett Howard.
Whenever I think of Columbus jazz, I think of the name Arnett Howard. From the early age of 16, he has been a part of the Columbus jazz scene. Having played with jazz greats like Metronomes, the Soul Internationals, and the Soul Superbs, not to mention his own band, the Arnett Howard Creole Funk Band, which he started in 1988. Howard played in the jazz circuits for many years, all while capturing the history of Columbus Black music scene. Howard contributed thousands of history music photos to the Columbus Metropolitan Library that I use to this very day. We recognize Arnett Howard as one of Columbus's great storytellers and historians, and this is why he is this year's recipient of the Respect History Award.
dedication to the Columbus Black History Respect History Award, Arnett Howard. I'm going to find a very prominent, I'll put it right in the middle of my desk, because this desk kind of holds everything. Some things for a little longer, but this will stay here for a while. I'm honored. I don't think I have ever received a history award before. So to receive this history award is a first for me. And thank you, Ms. Rita Fuller-Yates, number one, being inspired by my work. It is inspiring.
Thank you to our sponsors, Brittsmart and Studio V. Thank you to the singer, Tina Thompson. And especially thank you to the visionary and historian, who none of this would be possible without her, Rita Fuller-Yates and the Rita Fuller-Yates brand. We hope all of you tune in, like and share the page, and continue with Columbus Black History. Thank you.